One of the big goals for 2022 is we are going to get our first on-camera ace. Not today. Yep, not today. What is up, YouTube fam? Robbie C here. We are back with a brand new year after taking a few weeks off because really, if we're being honest, Vlogmas was a lot. What I want to do today is give you a few markers that you can use so that when you come back to this point next year, you can truly answer the question and say, am I actually any better this year than I was last year? So first is, how do we define what those markers are going to be? I'm a firm believer that you should start at the basket and work your way back towards the tee box. And when setting our goals, it's no different. Which means the first thing we're going to do to measure our goals is use the game Perfect Putt 360. There have been some really lame people that are doing their best to break up the good work Perfect Putt 360 is doing. So there was a brief moment where the app had to come off the app store. So I want to take a quick moment to explain the game just in case the app isn't available right now. The game is simple. You set up 5 different stations ranging from 10 feet all the way out to 30 feet. At each station, you're going to putt 10 times. You get an extra point for making the first one, and you get an extra point for making the last one. The app itself has a scaling system based on how far the putts are, but for the purpose of resolutions, you just want to keep track of how many putts you've made. But what I want you to do is make 4 rotations in total. That's right, 200 putts, and I want you to mark your averages at each of the stations. Once you've got these numbers, write them down in a handy-dandy notebook that you can either look back to next year or try to improve on throughout the rest of this year. Knowing that there's added pressure on sinking the first putt, or man, I've got to sink this last putt, this clutch gene that you're simulating in the practice course is exactly how you translate your success from the practice green out to the actual round. But what if I told you that I actually don't like putting that much, and one of the easiest ways to avoid putting is to be very good at upshots? For me, I'm considering an upshot anything 250 feet and in. Now, I totally understand that for many people, 250 feet is their max distance, and that's okay. You're gonna see some adjustments listed on the screen. So how do we measure our upshot success? Well, it's pretty simple. We just throw a lot of upshots. I forgot to explain an important part about putting, and that is the comfort circle. The comfort circle is where you believe you can make 85 to 90% of your putts. Knowing your comfort circle is critical because in this upshot drill, you want to know how big of a circle to create. And because you have all of this wonderful data from running all of your putts, you're going to know exactly how big your comfort circle is. Such as this putt right here. Yeah, not inside my comfort circle. But sometimes you get lucky. For the upshot drill, you're going to place a target in the middle and then create a circle all the way around it. The radius of this circle will be determined by your comfort circle. For me personally, my comfort circle is about 22 feet and in. Because of that, I set up a circle that's 30 feet across or 15 feet to the middle. Now, why did I shrink it? Because if I can land inside of that zone, then the putts are even easier because they're so far inside of my comfort circle. One of the cool parts about this though, is that as you saw, even if I land outside of my comfort circle or outside of this target area, you still have the opportunity to make the putt. The next thing I'm going to do is set up 4 stations, ranging from 100 feet all the way out to 250 feet. At each station, I'm going to throw 20 backhand shots and 20 forehand shots. I would suggest throwing 10 at a time, walking up, collecting your discs, coming back, and then throwing 10 more. Trying to find similar discs is going to make this process way easier and way more accurate, but you really can vary how you want to do this. I'm then going to mark how many of the shots are landing inside of the circle and how many shots are landing outside of the circle. This is going to give you very real data that you can use to know, hey, I am pretty accurate 100 feet and in, and I'm pretty not accurate 250 feet and in. If 250 feet is nearing your max distance full power shot, then substitute that station for a 50-foot station so that you can practice giving it a soft run from a longer putting distance. When I do this drill throughout the year, I do 100 shots backhand and 100 shots forehand from each station. My arm does not feel great on the other side of it, but my confidence is absolutely soaring. Plus, it gives you real data that you can use so that when you're on the course and you're 150 feet away from the basket, you know, hey, I can just take one step into a backhand and I know what this feels like because I've done it before. So we've dialed in the putts. We are not putting because we're throwing great upshots, which means really, what else do we have to work on? Tee shots and really, I guess just playing the round. Yeah. That's kind of important. If we're being honest, tee shots are a very difficult thing to practice because every tee shot seems to be different. There's different distances, different lines, and the conditions can be wildly different. Also, being transparent, I'm pretty confident all of us are usually pretty comfortably aware of how far we can throw, so I don't really think it's necessarily to go out and measure distance, because if I were to ask you right now, how far can you throw, you probably have an answer for that. Which means my final two measurements are all about how you can score while you're on a course. I want you to pick a course that isn't necessarily challenging, but also isn't one that you just totally demolish either. This course should have some holes that present some challenge, but overall you feel pretty comfortable when you're out there on the track. Once you've selected the course, you're going to play one round with your entire bag, but make sure that you don't just record your score, but also record the pin positions and the conditions that you're playing in. If you're playing on a super windy day and then you come back a year later and play on a calm day, it's going to look different just because of those conditions alone. After you record your round with your full bag, you're going to step up and do one of my favorite ways to measure how you're actually playing as a player, and that is putter-only round. When we play putter-only rounds, we often find ourselves in less trouble because we're making wiser decisions while we're out there on the course, but it also teaches us that sometimes we don't need that big distance driver to score just as well on the hole. You're going to take your full bag round and your putter-only round and average those two scores together, and this is going to be our marker for next year. If you haven't gathered already, I'd like to see averages. Everyone can throw a really good shot once or a really poor shot once. Averages are one of our best ways of telling how we're actually doing so that we can get some real data to look at. I don't care if you've thrown 480 feet once, I want to know how far you throw if we average 10 throws in a row together. In the same light, you may hold the course record on a course because you shot an amazing round and you were hitting every putt you could possibly imagine, but that doesn't mean that's the type of player you are exactly. That might just be your ceiling right now. These are all about finding your averages so that we can see where you're at right now so that we can celebrate together when you improve so much over the next year. As a bonus tip or measurement, I want you to go through and list out discs that you've tried before that feel almost unusable right now. Maybe they're too overstable for you and you can't get them to fly straight, or you just really don't seem to enjoy it. Write that list down, and I promise you that we're going to reference that about 6 months from now when you've made some improvements. 2022 is going to be a big year for all of us, and if you want to hear what some of my goals are for 2022, let me know in the comments below, and if there's interest, we'll do a video on it. With all that said, I just want to say thank you for being here and watching these videos. Thank you for letting me be a part of your disc golf journey. It is something I do not take lightly. We are all improving together, and I can't wait to see where we stand at the end of 2022. With all that said, I hope you have an amazing rest of the week and a fantastic start to this new year. But for now, I'm gonna leave you with the birdie.